您好，我是沈琳，欢迎收看这一期的《天下纵横谈》。德国的哲学家尼采说，人类因梦想而伟大，而因为有了梦想，逐梦才会更为踏实，到最后梦想才有办法成为真实的一面，这也就是我们所谓的人生。到底人生当中有多少个梦想可以怎么样的实现呢？我们今天非常荣幸邀请到了626 Market Founder， 也就是 Johnny 黄，跟我们讨论一下他的梦想到底是怎么实现的。 Johnny 您好。
Hi, I'm Johnny Huang, founder of 626 Night Market.
Mm-hmm. Johnny, I did a little research about you. 626 started at 2011.
Yes.
Correct? When it first started, you did quote yourself, said it was like a nightmare because everyone that's on Yelp actually gave you a negative review. So you have to lock yourself in your own room and be like, you know what, you have to think about it. 怎么样有办法从一个很 negative review 的地方2011年每年不断的做不断的做一直到今年2017年还越做越大。
Oh, wow, you brought back some bad memories.
Aww.
But no, I think in the beginning, we learned a lot. And I think once you learn from your experiences and you have a good support group,then you should be able to come back and do better. So, you know, every year we try to come back and evolve our events and make them more interesting, more attractive, more vendors, bigger space, bigger layout. Yeah, so I think that's the challenge for us every year is to come back and do something interesting.
So, 其实你有一个蛮大的 supporting group.Okay, support group 里面其实就可以帮你 overcome 很多的 difficulties,、mm-hmm. even 是可能是 review 啊，可能是人家进到626里面讲的事情，或者是这些 vendor 也有可能 ，right？ 可是每一年都会觉得越做越好，
对，
都想要越做越好，
没错
，right？ You were not a business major,
no,
you were
no.
a film major,
right? Right?
Correct?
Yeah, film
and
writing.
You were not even born.In Taiwan. You were born here?
No, I was born in Taiwan.
Oh, you were born
but
in
I
Taiwan.
Came when I was small, like 3 or 4.
Mm-hmm, but yeah. in Texas?
No, in Kansas.
No. Oh, close. In Kansas, that's right. Yeah. So you know what the geography was
like. Yeah. Kansas, mm-hmm. because my dad went to school there, and then Monterey Park.
Yeah, uh-huh. 然后你 moved 到 Monterey Park, 对不对？ Yeah. 然后之后你长大了以后又 moved to Taiwan.
Exactly.
对不对？ Right. 在台湾你好像开了一家美式的餐厅。
Yes, yes.
Is that correct?
Yeah, so like a bar and restaurant.
So you know how to cook?
No, we had a cook that was much better than me, so uh-huh, it was good.
But why did you want to open up like an American bar slash restaurant in Taiwan?
Back in the day, I was really into hip-hop, and I was a DJ, and at that time in Taiwan, hip-hop wasn't really big. It was usually just top, you know, 40 and mm-hmm. a lot of old stuff, and there wasn't really a hip-hop or even really of a club scene as we know it today in Taipei, or even 10 years ago. So, Yeah, I thought it would be interesting to bring some of that hip-hop culture over to Taiwan because it was becoming more and more popular there. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we wanted to introduce Taiwan, which is kind of, you know, what we wanted to do with the night market is to introduce that Taiwanese, you know, Asian night market concept over here.
Yeah, that was actually my second question. 我就要问说，其实你那时候想要做一个美式餐厅在台湾，所以其实它是一个截然不同的东西。Mm-hmm. 你在台湾有个美式餐厅，我相信在那个时候应该是没有太多像这样的餐厅的嘛 ，right?
Yeah, yeah. So our main thing was we were playing hip hop, but then we were trying to introduce kind of American foods.
or, like what? Hamburger
foods,
and fries?
Yeah, you can find in America, not necessarily from America. So we had.Sloppy Joe hamburgers,
oh.
and then we actually had pho as well,
no
which,
way.
You know, is huge in LA, and obviously yes. it's from Vietnam, but uh-huh. in Taiwan, there's, at that time,
there's
know, 04, 05, there wasn't.
Wow, yeah. 我想在台湾那个时候，04、05年的时候，他们可能连 Sloppy Joe 是什么都不知道吧
yeah, yeah, and I don't think they have it anymore.
Yeah, 一个汉堡就汉堡好好吃就好了，弄得还要什么 chili 在上面，然后有的没有的，这样怎么吃？Right, that was a brand new idea. 所以是把那个 idea 转到美国，因为你回到美国了、
mm-hmm.
，right? With your wife, 回到美国之后， right, right. 然后也想要把台湾的626带到美国来，让大家看一看到底所谓的 night market 是什么。
You know, when you're in LA and you see all these different cultures and different great foods,、mm-hmm. and then you come to San Gabriel Valley, there's a lot of, you know, Chinese, Vietnamese restaurants, and it's very intimidating for.Non-locals from around here to come into the restaurants and get the good food. They'll just order food that they already know, like Kung Pao chicken or some, you know, stuff that locals
Beef
don't really
and broccoli.
Eat. Exactly, exactly, yeah. or fried rice.
Yes.
So we thought it would be great to have a platform like 626 Night Market, an event that attracts a lot of different people, and then you have all these different food vendors that can come out and showcase their talent, basically, mm-hmm. their cooking talent. But, you know, we wanted to expand that. The night markets in Asia are usually just about food and,
yes.
you know, some shopping and games. But we wanted to have all that, but also add, you know, kind of any talent, yeah, that would reflect our community. So whether you're a chef or an entrepreneur or a crafter or an artist or a performer, a filmmaker, mm-hmm. you know, dancer, scientist, like we want to try to be able to have activities that reflect our community and that people would be interested in. So every year, we try to add new activities. This year, we're adding gaming, right? Esports yeah. is becoming big, so we're going to have gaming tournaments for our last two events. Mm-hmm. And then we're also bringing in drone racing because that's, you know, kind of a new thing that's coming out. So yeah, we always want to change it up. We had Caltech out the last event, oh. you know, doing some more science stuff because obviously a lot of people in our community are interested in science and, mm-hmm. and STEM. Mm. So. Yeah, we don't, obviously food is our main attraction, but we want to have a lot of different activities.
Well, food is actually something that brings everyone together.
Exactly.
That's the same exactly. common ground, right?
Right.
所以有这个 cornerstone, 因为大家因为食物因为好吃的食物而结合在了一起。可是到了这个66 Night Market, 或是 OC Night Market 的时候你又可以看到不一样的事情就像你刚刚提到的、mm-hmm. 你想要有 entertainer, 他可以唱歌可以做 hip-hop, 或者你可以想要做 science 这个部分的东西、
right.
或者是 gaming, 甚至是我们所谓的 STEM, educational 的东西。
Right.
你都想要把它融合在 626
exactly.
Night Market 或是 OC Night Market 里面、
exactly.
因为这个就是我们所谓的 LA community、mm-hmm. 我们就把所有的 community 的人都结合在一起了、
mm-hmm.
2011 to 2017Okay, it has been 6 years already. It's been growing and growing every year. Every year, 626, 还有 OC Night Market, 都是不一样的成长，不一样的阶段。Mm-hmm. 当然，我希望它每年都可以继续下去。每年这么继续下去，会不会觉得有什么比较困难的地方？
I think innovating and coming up with new activities is always difficult.
Mm-hmm.
But we do that by, you know, not only instilling it in our team, just to keep thinking, you know, what's fresh and what are people interested in. We try to instill that culture in our vendors as well, because, you know, they're an extension of our team and the event, obviously. People go there for the vendors. So we always try to encourage them to innovate and evolve their products, right? Try something new or, you know, put a twist on it.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously the traditional ones are also welcome.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah. The vendors are actually another key point for 626 and OC Night Market too. 而且我知道你好像有写一个 blog, 对不对、
mm-hmm.
你在那个 blog 上面还有 invite 你的 vendor 上去讲、mm-hmm. 所以其实我觉得想要知道626 Night Market 或者 OC Night Market 的人想要认识你的人如果今天讲出来有关于任何626 Night Market 的东西他甚至可以了解到 vendor 背后的故事、
mm-hmm.
The story behind the vendor.
Exactly.
Uh-huh. That brings your people who goes to the night market and、
right.
the vendor even a little bit closer.
Exactly, yeah.
Right?
We want, you know, the vendors to be able to showcase not just their food and products, but、
mm-hmm.
their story. You know,、
yes.
I think people like to hear about entrepreneur stories and, you know, where they came from, why did they want to open up this booth and what are their goals、
mm-hmm.
beyond that.
Yeah, just like people want to hear about your story.
Oh, well, I don't know
about that, but. Well, no, people really do want to know because 2011 to 2017, of、mm-hmm. course, there's a lot of up and downs、
right.
when you're doing this, especially during summertime. 66 is only in summer,
right?
Right. What do you do outside of summertime?、
Planning
the whole year?
Yeah, we prepare、
oh,
a lot、
for
the next event, for the next year. We start vendor signups early. This、
oh.
past summer, we developed an internal software system to manage our vendors better.
Wow.
And then, you know, the next year,We're planning、some more growth. So yeah, we try to keep ourselves busy. But definitely we, you know, take a couple months off and、you know, decompress and、
True.
Relax. Because once the season starts, it's...
It's crazy,
yeah,
right?
It's
How
crazy.
Many hours do you work per day on a daily basis during the season? Do you sleep only 4 hours a day?
No,
kind of?
In the beginning I did. But, you know, through the years we've built a great team and everybody knows their responsibilities and、
mm-hmm.
they're...become experts at producing these events. So fortunately, I can get a little bit more than that.
Okay, 所以你可以睡五个小时。
Yeah, yeah.
我想要知道，当然现在有很多新的 entrepreneur 想要知道你的 successful story, 你告诉他们了。有没有什么 suggestion 告诉他们 how to become successful?
I think specifically for the Asian audience is, you know, don't listen to your parents. Like, if you have a goal that you want to do and that you believe in yourself, try it. And, you know, you might succeed the first time, but chances are you won't, you know, just like we did it, our first event. But keep trying, learn from it, come back, be humble, and you'll keep learning and you'll keep improving. And one day you'll make it, and then your parents will be very proud of you.
Yeah.
And yeah, it'll be very rewarding.
I understand. Asian parents are always like that. It's either you be lawyer or you're the doctor. Right, otherwise, right, you're right, unsuccessful right. in your life. Unfortunately,
right.
人类真的是因为梦想而伟大。
You know, me and everyone on my team, our parents were all like that, you know. My parents didn't want me to start a night market, and neither did theirs, or to work for one. But now, you know, they tell all their friends that, hey, my son or my daughter does the night market, and they're actually very proud.
他们好有面子
，right?
Not in the beginning, 爸爸妈妈就是这样。Yeah, not in the beginning. 可是其实你还是知道他们都是 very supportive, 只是那个脸上面没有觉得这么 supportive. 可是还是很担心你的爸爸妈妈就是这样。
Exactly.
所以人类真的是因为有了梦想而伟大。就像Johnny提到的，其实他在2011年开始626还有 OC Night Market 真的是并不太成功的。可是因为他的执着，他想要认真做事，他想要不断的学习，才可以让626还有 OC Night Market 不断的茁壮，不断的成长。如果你也有梦，你也可以因为梦想而伟大。欢迎回到这一节的天下纵横谈。其实呢，科技呢真的是天天都在变哦。在十年前，也许还没有一个手机的萤幕，甚至是点触控的萤幕。十年以后，竟然手机是人人都有。那么科技它的变化到底在我们的社区当中做了什么样的一种不同的变化呢？而其实 American Echo 的 William Hahn 到底又在科技当中扮演着什么样的角色呢？这一节的天下纵横谈里面，我们邀请到了两位嘉宾，跟我们一起讨论一下，到底科技还有 American Idol 之中到底有什么样的不同处，甚至是有什么样的相同之处。首先为您介绍的呢是圣马力诺华人协会的周克吉周会长。
大家好，我是周克吉、今年2017年的圣马力诺华人协会的会长、英文名字是 John Chow。 那另外我也是、Friday Coffee Meetup 在 Pasadena 的一个 co-organizer。
Hi, welcome, John. 接着呢，为各位介绍的是 American Idol She Bangs 的 singer， 也就是 William Hahn。William， 您好。
Hello， 大家好，我是 William Hahn 孔庆祥。我是参加过的 American Idol 的比赛。
Wow, William, you can speak Chinese so well.
一点点啊。
一点点啊。可是广东话比较好，对不对？
是，对对对。
Hey, John, 你刚刚 mention 到，其实你除了是圣马力诺华人协会的会长之外，刚刚提到一个 Friday Coffee Meetup 是吗？
对。
这是什么样的一个 organization？
是每一个星期五除了 holidays 以外，我们在 Pasadena 有一个 Friday Coffee Meetup。这个是一个 meetup， 就是给所有的startup tech companies， 就是有个机会给大家聚一聚，认识一下，然后也听一些guest speakers， 就是讲startup business， startup technology companies 的一些pointers 跟一些困难。有一些什么可以就是帮助、他们的。
所以其实、Friday Coffee Meetup 它是为了这些新的 business person create 的一个早上八点半大家一起坐下来聊天的一个聚会吗？
这个我们是有一个会请一个 guest speaker， 然后 guest speaker 大部分都会有经验，就是有的时候是他们是一个technology expert， 比方说我们今天早上有一个 speaker 是讲 personal artificial intelligence， 那有的时候也会有VC， 就是 venture capitalist， 就是说他们是找什么样子的公司可以去投资。那另外也有startup serial entrepreneurs， 这些就是很有经验的人，他们会跟大家讲他们以前用什么方法去开始他们的business， 然后很多时候这些 entrepreneurs 也有很 successful 的 exit， 那他们 exit 以后 为什么他们会再继续啊 start up 一个新的啊 startup？ 所以我们有这种这样子的啊 guest speakers 啊来跟大家就是跟啊讲一下，
一起做分享。
对
，right？ OK， 所以其实你刚刚提到了，我们会有很多 tech 的 expert 或者是 entrepreneur、嗯、或者是 serial 的这些 entrepreneur 一起来当做 guest speaker、嗯。
对，
可是这个是一个 American Idol 哎，so was William one of the speakers？
啊、对啊、，William 也是我们啊、一个 speaker。
啊哈，
那你也知道，当一个startup business 是不简单的事情啊、常常啊、这些公司会啊、还不到、go to market 以前，他们就会啊、就 fail 就失败。嗯、所以啊、我们啊、也是有一我们有一些这些 speakers， 他们就是会跟我们说，为什么啊、他们成功啊、为什么他们有这个 focus 或者这个 perseverance？ 那我们请了 William 来跟我们就是讲。给我们的这个 inspirational motivational speaking， 因为他在、American Idol 的时候、当然很多人看见他的 audition 的时候也知道他也有、有一点 criticism 跟一些困难、尤其是 Simon Cowell 对他有一点不是很
原谅。Yes, very harsh. I remember those clips.
对，那为什么、William 他会跟我们、share 给我们听他的那个、他后来怎么利用那个experience 这个经验，所以他可以就是现在变成一个 motivational 跟 inspirational speaker。
Ah, so William, you were actually at the Friday coffee meetup as a inspirational and motivator.
Yeah, 是啊，是啊，
是啊，哇、OK， 所以你是怎么样从 American Idol 转变成为一个 inspirational and motivator 的？
我当初啦表演也很久了，因为呢我当时试音的时候呢是2004 2004 三年前
right? Yeah.
对呀、
How did that transform go about？
就是呢因为 我很多年都会有、旅游唱歌表演、mm-hmm. 很多地方都有去过、
yeah.
但是我觉得呢表演 之后呢就没有什么事情了，我觉得就是人家 很容易就会 忘记了我。
哦、oh, people forget about you very easily. No, people don't forget about you.
不是
people still remember you.
不是这样的，都是我觉得这个感觉不一样了，可以这样说了。
Mm-hmm.
因为我觉得今年开始我才开始演讲。
Okay.
我觉得演讲的地方好的地方就是呢，不只是娱乐人家。就是能够分享自己的故事、自己的经验，可以帮助有需要的人。
OK， 所以其实不是只是娱乐大家，他是可以分享自己的故事、嗯、还可以分享自己的经验、嗯、然后用你的故事来帮助其他的人。
没错。
Yeah, 我想要知道的是你在 Friday Coffee Meetup 做了什么样的分享？
就是分享了13年的很多有很有趣的事情。
讲一件来跟我们分享一下，好吗？
没关系。
Yeah,
uh-huh. 就是呢，例如呢，我试音当 Fox 这个电视台播了我的American Idol 之后呢，其实我什么都没有想过的，没有我不知道会怎么样的、
uh-huh.
但是呢很奇怪的事情呢，播完之后呢，哇 150 emails 150个电邮过来。
很 shock。
哎呀，是啊，
是不是、
他们、yeah. 他们、有电视、表演机会啊，电影表演机会啊、
mm-hmm.
哇，很奇怪啊、
mm-hmm. 然后呢，可是你觉得很奇怪，你会不会觉得也有一点 overwhelming as well？
是啊，我不知道什么回事啊、
uh-huh. 那怎么办呢？
怎么办就是我觉得人生呢有时候呢机会只有一次，这些东西，所以我觉得应该要绑压这个机会。
机会只有一次，所以一定要把握这个机会。John, I think I can feel William.、
Mm-hmm.
So when he is actually delivering a motivative message,、
mm-hmm.
you can actually feel that.Is that one of the purpose for Friday Coffee Meetup?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Well, and actually that is something that William was able to convey to the audience. 除了大人以外，他也是他 motivational speaking 也是有跟比较年轻的人，尤其是 teenagers。那我是觉得这个也是很有效，因为你也知道，学生尤其是 teenagers， 他们也不知道以后他们大学去哪里，以后career 要去做什么。那听 William 他的那个motivational speaking 的时候，他们可以听见一个人的就是。就让大家知道没有关系，你不用担心，你有这个机会的话 ，make the best of it、mm-hmm.。I think that's the main message that William is sending to his audience.
Yes.、Mm. Hey, William, 那刚才 John 有提到，就是其实你的 audience 可能也有比较小一点的，像 teenagers， 那当然也有年纪比较中等的，或是年纪比较大一点的。对于这三个不同的年龄层，你会怎么样告诉他们 to follow their dreams？
我觉得就是你的心 你的心想做什么你就要去做，不要让自己后悔、
嗯、不要让自己后悔。可是有时候你知道爸爸妈妈的要求是很不一样的，
没错、啊
right?
没错，
有时候爸爸就会说你要读书读书读书，一定要做这个，不可以唱歌、啊、那这样就会有亲子关系之间的冲突啊。
没错，
有没有经历过？
当然有啊。我的爸妈我的爸妈基本不想我去 American Idol 的、
哦、他根本不想让你去 American Idol。
没错啊、uh-huh. 他 如果我跟他们说的话呢，他们不会让我去的，他们会说、uh-huh.你不是最好唱歌最好的哪一个啊，你没有拒绝
呀、yeah, 你会马上被拒绝的、yeah, right?
啊、
那怎么办、
啊、那 我 好的地方就是当时呢我在三藩市 San Francisco、
oh, so your parents were not there
yeah, 所以没有所以 我就不用告诉他们啊自己的静静地就去了，
就去了，然后之后就做了一个很大的新闻，大家都认识 William， 、啊、然后爸爸妈妈也会跟你说 Good job， 、right?
不是啊，
没有吗？
他们也很奇怪，觉得哇，怎么回事啊？ Uh-huh, 你读书怎么会这样？
Yeah. 读书读成这样，
对呀、啊。Yeah.
可是 eventually 他们还是 accepted 吧？
呀、yeah, 是啊，
还是会
是、啊、
还是会很会为你高兴。
是啊，
对不对、
啊？
其实我觉得这样，很多 entrepreneur 都会这样子，就是遇到很多事情，可能就是。这些事情都不是家里愿意去 support 的、
mm-hmm. right? 对
at least 他至少在 Friday Coffee Meetup、mm-hmm. 他可以找到一个、mm-hmm. 不只是一个很单纯的 motivational 的 speaker、mm-hmm. 他可以找到我们所谓的 tech expert、mm-hmm. 甚至是 business expert、mm-hmm. at least a supporting group、mm-hmm.
对，
因为他的 peer 都是一样的，
对，
对不对？
对，嗯、所以他们是说，start a business 有一个很重要的重点，就是要找一个 good team members， 因为很多一个business 很难就是一个人去 start up。那你要是有一些缺点的话，比方说你有个很好的 idea， 或者你是对 marketing 很有经验，可是你没有这个 tech background 的话，那怎么办？所以找一个 tech partner 的话，也许是有很大的帮助。所以我们的那个 meetup 他们就有这个机会可以多认识一些不同的人，说不定可以认识一个就是可以当 partner 跟你有不同的 experience 跟 background、mm-hmm. 合作的话，说不定就会有一些 synergy 就可以就是帮助成功的机会。
嗯 Wally 你是不是也参加了，你除了是去当 speaker 之外，你是不是也参加了一个 Friday Coffee Meetup as an audience？
有啊，因为我觉得这个也很好，写的东西也不错，所以、uh-huh. 所以有时间的话就会去。
Are you a tech person yourself？
我是啊， oh. 因为呢，我觉得我做这个演讲表演的东西呢， mm. 因为最难的地方呢，就是要很快，很有 efficient， 有很、mm-hmm. 很好的方法去 contact 很多人才可以成功。Mm-hmm. 这个就是其中一个 secret。
Okay.
我的 secret， 因为也不是 secret， 就是 难的地方。
最难的地方就是在那边、嗯、怎么样可以用最有效率的方式、嗯、在最短的时间之内 contact 到最多的人，
没错，
这是你想要可以做到的，
没错。
而当然啦 Friday Coffee Meetup 就可以帮助到，就会就算是有 tech background 的人、嗯、或者是没有 tech background 的人都可以帮助到。
对，没错。
今天非常谢谢 William， 非常谢谢 John 来我们的天下纵横谈，跟我们提到了呢，其实科技真的是天天都在变，如果你没有跟得上科技的脚步的话，其实你就真的落伍了。就像 William 一样，他在10年前是 American Idol， 可是现在因为 Friday Coffee Meetup 变成了另外一个 Tech 的 Idol。 如果你对 Friday Coffee Meetup 也有相关的感兴趣的话，记得到 meetup.com 去找一下到底什么是 Friday Coffee Meetup。